in Nigeria said Tuesday nearly 100 hostages, including women and children, have been rescued more than 2 months after they were abducted by armed groups in northwest Nigeria. Among the 97 freed hostages are 19 babies and more than a dozen children, according to the state's police chief, coming a few days after 21 school children were freed by security forces. The rescue is bringing relief in Nigeria, where armed groups have killed thousands and kidnapped many residents and travelers in exchange for ransoms. Police said the hostages were, quote, rescued unconditionally Monday in a joint security operation targeting the camps of armed groups that have been terrorizing remote communities across the northwest and center of Africa's most populous country. Sudanese took to the streets in the capital of Khartoum and other cities on Tuesday in anti-coup protest as the country plunged further into turmoil following the resignation of the prime minister earlier this week. Security forces fired tear gas to disperse protesters in several locations in the capital, including the area around the presidential palace, which has seen clashes in previous rounds of protests since the October 25th coup. Protesters were also seen in videos hurling stones and used tear gas canisters at security forces. There was no immediate reports of casualties. Prime Minister Abdallah Hamdok was ousted in the coup, only to be reinstated a month later following a deal with the military meant to calm tensions and anti-coup protests. But he stepped down Sunday amid political deadlock, saying he failed to find a compromise between the ruling generals and the pro-democracy movement. U.S. authorities on Tuesday charged a Colombian man with conspiracy to commit murder or kidnapping outside the United States in connection with the assassination of Haitian President Jovenel Moïse, the first official charges in the brazen crime. Haiti has arrested dozens of people following the July murder that left a political vacuum in the Caribbean nation. But it has not charged anyone, and the investigation has drawn complaints in the country about delays and intimidation of officials. The U.S. Justice Department says the former Colombian military officer was part of a conspiracy that first planned to kidnap Moïse, but evolved into an assassination plot after conspirators were unable to find a plane to take the president out of Haiti. The U.S., Britain, France, and Australia all announced record numbers of daily COVID-19 cases Tuesday. Britain breached 200,000 cases for the first time, Australia posted almost 50,000, and France registered more than 270,000, all three countries easily topping their previous records. But dwarfing those numbers was the more than 1 million reported by the United States on Monday, a global record. The country's Monday figures are usually higher due to delays in weekend tallying and were likely inflated further after a three-day New Year's holiday weekend. The rolling average over 7 days, which experts see as more reliable, was 486,000 cases per day as of Monday evening, Johns Hopkins University said. French prosecutors said on Tuesday they had launched a terrorism investigation after a French vehicle involved in the Paris-Dakar rally race in Saudi Arabia last week exploded, injuring one of the rally competitors. In a statement, the prosecutors said the explosion happened on December 30th in the Saudi city of Jeddah. It said five French nationals had been in the vehicle at the time of the blast. French news outlet France Info reported on January 1st that an explosion hit a support vehicle being used by a French rally team. Citing the race director, France Info said the explosion happened as the support vehicle left the team hotel to head to the start of the race stage. It said the co-driver of the team's race car suffered a serious leg injury and had to be hospitalized. Again, French prosecutors said on Tuesday they launched a terrorism investigation after a French vehicle involved in a race in Saudi Arabia last week exploded.